there are times whereby you go on stage and you see people holding microphones, and you see some of them doing like this. You see some of them doing like using the microphone like this, like a pastor's preaching or a minister doing like microphone like this. Or you see Phil Thompson doing like this. Now, if you look at that video of Phil Thompson, you notice that when he dropped his microphone to the floor, his hand was still up like this. If you're watching the video, he didn't drop the microphone like this when he dropped it on the floor. His microphone was still facing up because this guy is conscious in his mind. A lot of times, a lot of backup artists, when they are on stage, maybe they've forgotten themselves, they just drop the microphone like this. And that leads to feedback because you are pointing the magnet to the other magnet, that is the speaker. So you have to be conscious when you are standing on stage as a vocalist or a performer. You have to always hold your microphone up. And if you notice, none of them, there was no one among them that was holding the microphone like this, or like this, or like this. And you know, we see a lot of gangster rappers, a lot of people in the Nigerian industry, that they hold the microphone like this. They hold it like this. They hold it like this. Some of them hold it like this. And you know, I also see likes like Jay-Z, likes like Fred Hammond. So I don't want them to hold the microphone like this. But you know the secret? It is what we see that we know. What we don't see, we don't know. Most times, all these artists out there, they have a chain of processing that go into all those microphones. Like they use series of processes. It's not just your regular EQ on your console. At times it could be if the engineer is very, very good. And sometimes, but most times it's always a chain. Like most times they use like Pultec type EQ. Like all these passive equalizers where you can take out a frequency and still add it back. So if a speaker is sounding bad, you can take it out and still add it back without it sounding the way it was before. You get what I'm saying? So all those things go through series of processes. But in Nigeria, where some of the mix engineers we have are not so experienced, most times they just move the low frequency. And the funniest part is they do the wrong thing, because they say my people perish because of lack of knowledge. You know, when you don't know something, you don't know how to fix it. You just do it the way you feel is right. And there are some ways they fix all this kind of thing. When you have somebody holding a microphone like this, there are ways in which you apply EQ to those things and it don't sound that bad. But because people don't know, they don't know. So, I do a lot of training in that. So if you want to know, you can just holler at your boy. Yeah. So, back to what I was talking about. So, I want to employ a lot of anybody using the microphone. You have to know how to use your microphone. Now, the right way to use cardioid microphone is to hold this. You can go like this. This is the right way to use the microphone. Check. If you want to scream into the microphone, you can go a little bit higher like this. But when you go like this, you're on your own. Or you go like this, you're on your own. You are away. You are totally off. You might still pick you a little bit if the gain is really, really hot. But because of feedback, you don't want to push too much of gain. So you're doing like this. So if you want to scream, you can go like from like this to like this. Cause I know the smallest voices, they can make it major. I got my boys with me, at least those in favor. And if we don't meet before I leave, instead of doing this is wrong. Like you are far away from your microphone, you lose depth and you lose volume. Now that's for a cardioid polar pattern microphone. Now for a super cardioid polar pattern microphone, which is this. If you do like this, you're away from the microphone. The best thing you can do is to take it at the same level. If you can go like this, but immediately you are off that microphone, you are off this axis. You are totally, in fact, this microphone is very unforgiving. Very unforgiving. It's a very wicked microphone. Now, before I go further, I want to explain a term. We call it proximity effect. Now, that this proximity effect works with dynamic microphones. This proximity effect works with mostly dynamic microphones. In fact, all dynamic microphones, like all this Sennheiser series and this T-Bone, the Superlock series, this one I took. But when it comes to condenser mics, that principle of proximity effect doesn't really work with them. So that's why you see when a pastor is talking or anybody with a condenser mic talking, when you see them doing like this and the microphone is still picking them. We have microphones like the ULX, Shure ULX. You have the accents, and you have those are Shure like that. You know, you have Sennheiser, you have the SKM 5200 series, you have the SK 2000 series, you know, the G3, the G4, like that. You have a lot of mics like that that are condenser and they are cardioid. But this is condenser and it's a cardioid microphone. But the fact that it's a condenser, proximity effects don't work with him. So I want you to get that right. So that's just all we're going to talk about concerning types of microphones and polar patterns. So let me recap. I spoke about types of microphone, dynamic microphone. We have a condenser microphone. We have a boom mic. We have lapel mic. We have pressure zone mic. We have earthworm mics. So I explained dynamic microphones are the ones that proximity effects work with them because they are mostly rugged. They are actually rugged. They are very strong. They can fall and stand, and they are used for music, live concerts, and rest like that. Just so that dynamic microphones are the ones that have a restricted coverage. They are not sensitive around the microphone. This particular piece you have to put your mouth so that it will pick you. Just know that about dynamic microphone. So you have to be specific about what you are talking to. You cannot be flexing around with the dynamic microphone, but you can be flexing around with a condenser microphone because it gives you that flexibility. It is forgiving. It will give you that it will give you that feature to be able to play around, you know, to play around with your microphone and still get away with it, you know. You can still play around and do stuff and, you know, and it's still picking you. It's still picking you. So everyone are the ones that we use for presenters, pastors, gym instructors. You wear your hair, those are earth ones. The lapels are the one you clip on your mic. And I say those ones, they have issues with rustle, body movements, and so they are not really good for live performance. You have a lot of monitors because of feedback. But if you can use it and make it work, it's very, very okay. It's very, very okay. So shotguns are very direct. They are the most directive. They are the most directional microphones. They are used for filming videos, movies, because they cancel out a lot of wind noise or unnecessary noise by the side. They are, you know, one side is up, positive, one side is negative. So when they come together, they cancel each other. You get my point? We're not going to polar patterns. We have cardioid. Cardioid are this type. These are cardioid. This is a cardioid that I explained that they are sensitive at the front here. This is the way to use a cardioid microphone, like this or like this. You can still get away with this, but you are losing depth, but you can still use it, but you can't get away with this. You are far away from home, or this, you are far away from home like this. So the least you can do is to tilt a little bit, and it is null at this part. It's really nonsense. So you have to put your, if you're going to buy monitors for cardioid microphone, you have to, for cardioid polar pattern microphone like this, you have to get your floor monitors in front of you. If you're going to get a super cardioid microphone, it has to be by the side because they are not sensitive by the sides, but they need to be sensitive behind. So if you put floor monitor behind them, it will be feeding back because it is a little bit sensitive at the back. The directivity level of this is more than this. This is why this is narrow. So that's that. I talked about omnidirectional pattern. So this is an omnidirectional. It picks around. It's very flexible, very forgiving. It allows you to do as you like, do what you want. So it was a big world, but we thought we were bigger.